The Philippine General Hospital in Manila is expanding its bed allocation for COVID-19 patients to cope with the rising number of cases. The hospital is also implementing stricter health protocols to curb the spread of the novel coronavirus. Vivian Gulia has the story.
More than 100 COVID patients are currently admitted at the Philippine General Hospital, an over 50% increase compared to last month's figures. 25 more patients are on the waiting list.
We're about 70% occupied. Yung ICU nga namin nasa 80% na eh.
Marami nga yung numero pero ang mga nalalagay sa ICU ngayon and the severe cases, hindi ho kasing dami nung dati. So it's not true that we are being overrun by COVID patients. Na-overrun po kami ng non-COVID patients. Itong mga nakaraang buwan, kaya ngayon mag-a-adjust po lang po kami ulit.
The hospital attributes the rise in COVID cases to a couple of reasons.
Nag-ease up yung lockdown, tapos medyo people are more mobile. Baka medyo nakalimutan yung talagang yung mga minimum health protocols. At pangalawa ay maaring may effect din yung dahil may mga variants araw, yung UK and South African variant.
Del Rosario says of the 30 specimen from PGH's COVID patients, which underwent genome sequencing, one tested positive for the South African variant. PGH also saw a rise in the number of COVID infections among health workers, which hit 25 this March alone. 80 personnel have been quarantined after they were exposed to COVID-positive health workers, but none of them are critical.
Medyo high-risk procedures po yung ginagawa ng aming anesthesia team, ano? Many of them are in charge of what we call airway management. Minsan kahit po naka-PPE, talagang minsan nahahawa din, no? Pangalawa po, I think when we were looking at the situation, bakit ba nagkahawa-hawahan, may mga areas po na naging lax po yung iba naming healthcare workers. Minsan po, they eat in a relatively small room. Baka nakakalimutan nila. Siyempre, they have to remove their mask. At kung may hindi maganda yung ventilation ng lugar na yun, there's a chance na pwede kayong magkahawahan.
One patient who initially tested negative prior to surgery tested positive after the procedure.
Pwedeng, even before the surgery, nung swinab siya, ay pre-symptomatic, kaya negative. Minsan kasi hindi pa. Tapos, eto na. In short, nasa incubation period siya nung time na yon, no? Or it can also happen na nakuha niya sa ospital. Talagang it causes some distress into the system kasi po eh syempre everybody thought na ikaw ay COVID negative, tapos syempre operahan ka, so now there's an exposure of the whole team, of the people who are taking care of you.
PGH is implementing stricter protocols. Personnel are required to wear at least a KN95 mask in non-COVID areas and an N95 mask in COVID areas. The hospital also suspended the face-to-face clinical rotation of fourth and fifth year medical students, as well as walk-in patients.
Puro online appointment muna, and then they will have a telemedicine encounter with their doctors. At kung talagang na-clear na and they really need to be examined, kailangan makita, doon pa lang po sila pupunta sa PGH.
Ang tatanggapin po namin yung mga limb and life-threatening conditions, yung mga na-aksidente, trauma, at yung mga ng mga anak na hindi na mapigil, no? Those imminent deliveries.
PGH is also allocating more beds for COVID patients.
We're trying to recover some of the beds that we gave to our non-COVID patients. So we have two appeals. One is if some of the hospitals who are non-COVID referrals naman, if they can get our non-COVID patients so that now we can accept their COVID patients.
More PGH personnel have expressed interest to get vaccinated. The hospital started rolling out AstraZeneca's COVID vaccine Monday and Sinovac last week. Del Rosario says the hospital targets to complete the administration of the first COVID vaccine shot to eligible personnel in 2 weeks. Despite the increase in COVID cases, Del Rosario says they have yet to need a timeout. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.